All right, ready to go to school? Let's do it. Help me out. See you later, Rebecca. What, buddy? You have to say it a little bit louder. All right, we are on our way to Matias' school in Urubo, Montessori. Whoa, look at all the chickens. What are you doing out here? Little curb hop in action. There we go. All right. Looks clear. Here we go. They're gonna put pavers over there. Wow. Could be interesting. So we were just on the fifth ring, which is where we live, and we're heading down to the fourth ring. This area to the right over here is called the Playa. Playa means beach. It's obviously there's no beach, at least not the kind you might think of. This is where they come and sell cars. By the time we come back in about a half hour and 40 minutes, this whole area will be just completely jammed with cars for sale. This trip to school takes somewhere between around 25 minutes or so, give or take a few minutes. Depends on the traffic we run into. The motorcycle definitely speeds the process up, but at the same time, it's quite a bit more dangerous. We've had a few accidents. This year. Wow, look at that guy. He doesn't care. Don't care. Keep going. So now we're on the fourth ring. going to take this all the way around to the intersection, which then takes us over the bridge and into a place called Udubo, which is back in that place that Matias' school is located, in a barrio called Villa Bonita. There is significant traffic this morning. We are a few minutes behind schedule, not too bad. Nice. So I make this trip 2 times a day. Once in the morning to take Matias to school, and then once, right at noon, I usually leave the house to go back and pick him up. So he gets to school around 7:35 usually in the morning. I'm sorry. Yeah, 7:35. That's not gonna happen today, but he gets there at 7:35 typically. And from there, I'm back to the house at like 8:05-ish, depending on how long it takes me to get him. Get his gear off and get him ready for school. We're ready for class. Get a little bit of this. And somebody put a tire in our shortcut spot. Can't get up there. We'll still squeeze along the edge here. In the afternoon, I pick up around 12:35. We're back to the house by about 1:10, just in time to get some lunch. Sorry, Matty. So this intersection right here, if you were to take a left, this would take you eventually to El Torno. It's about 35 minutes on the motorcycle. Months ago, and you gotta be real careful going through here because we had an incident with a dog running out in front of us, and he hit it. Fortunately, we didn't go down. It did nothing to the bike. The dog went for a ride, swimming around on the road, but by the time I went back to check him out, he was already gone. It just kind of scared us. He was on the right side of the road and was crossing over to the left, and he was just at a full sprint. Maybe think that he was chasing after something. I had no time to brake, which was probably best. I just had barely enough time just to even let off the throttle a little bit. Thank you. Lane splitting is perfectly legal. So we do a lot of it, especially when we're stopped like this. You can make up a lot of ground, get ahead of everybody. I feel like it's safer. Get ahead of them and get them behind you. But it doesn't always work, as you can see right now. Somebody's too close to somebody else, you can't really get around them. Then you have people like this that decide to just park on the street. It's also kind of a common occurrence. Going about 30 miles an hour. And this guy's gonna stop here. You really gonna try and finish me off? Cut me off? Good. It's about just under 10 miles getting to a school. Let's do that there and back at 20, and then do it again in the afternoon. That's just under 40 miles that I'm doing a day. So 190 or so miles a week. Before Matias started school, I was basically just using this bike just for taking little trips, going to the tornos, just easy stuff like that. Just kind of for fun more than anything, for pleasure. Now it's become our daily commuter. We're racking up the miles like crazy. I think it's the first year and a half that I had it. And we put like 1,500, maybe 2,000 miles on it. And I'm putting 1,000 miles on it or better sometimes a month. So when his school started, the thing had around 12,000 miles on it, and we're over 17 now. I figure we'll be somewhere around 21, 22 by the time the school year is over. But it's been a really, really cheap means of transportation. We usually put 30 or 35 Louisianas with the gas in it a week. It's 7 B's to the dollar. You can do the math on that. I'm not paying very much. To take a taxi or even a bus would be more than that. So, All right, we've made it over here now to the intersection where we're going to cut off to the left, cross a couple of little bridges, and then head over to the school. Another little motorcycle shortcut here somewhere, but I don't know if we're going to be able to use it today. It's green, but slow to get moving. There it is. Gonna turn yellow on him, so let's go around this guy and then drop down here in the front. I don't think so. We can't tell what it is for sure though. Nothing. I think it's just a junker, dude. It says UM. Huh. Yeah. I don't know if it's considered a town or if it's considered part of the city, but it's all full of new housing developments. I think it's one of the more expensive places to maybe live. My piece of school used to be located on this same road that we're on right now, but heading the opposite direction. And at the end of the last school year, they made the move over here. They had been renting before, and then they bought this property. It's a nice place, but I think their hopes are to eventually keep adding levels. First grade, keep on moving, but they really don't have any room to do that where they're at right now. They've been adding some classrooms here and there, but it just doesn't seem very likely to me that they're going to be able to do that. We'll see what happens. This potentially could be the PS's first and last year there. So we're kind of in the process trying to figure out what to do. This is the Rio Piraí. Again, this way is kind of headed southwestward. You can see that it's really wide. There's not a lot of water. And that's apparently from people over several decades harvesting all the rocks out of the riverbed for construction purposes. And it's kind of like that throughout the whole way. I mean, it's not uncommon to see big trucks in there lifting out rocks, hauling them off. So it just kind of keeps eating away, eroding the banks. Sounds like Matias is having a good day. He's behind me there singing. You probably can't hear him, but that's a good indication. Here's where we... Wow, and that taxi's blocking the road. Two of them to let people off. Talk about dangerous. And you can see here where the other taxi's parked right there. That's where I got hit. Had an accident here. The lady from Matias' school, a mom, I should say, came down this hill up there, around the corner, on the cell phone, and just knocked me right off. Hey, Matthew. Huh. Wow. Here we are, Montessori. We made it, Matty. Get my gloves on. So I think this used to be just like a private residence, but they bought it and kind of converted it, and it works okay, at least in the short term. Buen dia. Okay, let's go, buddy. And he's off. Let's head inside, buddy. Buen día.
Sawtooth when I came to pick you up. Fix your hair a little bit. Ooh, we gotta go to the bathroom. It's a little out of control. Oh, I think I got it. Well, I think I got it.
Yay. I did it.
All right. Backpack on.
I wanna see first.
Okay. Man, it's an apple kind of day.
An apple cake. I'm not going to film my arm. I'm going to go play outside.
All right. See you later. Have a good day. How much yes?
You can't really look at the camera.
See you later, bud. Very well. Ciao, Mati. Have a good day, buddy. All right. Bye-bye. We're usually one of the first ones that gets here, so he's got some time to get settled in and do some playing on the playground. Although it's just kind of the rainy season, so oftentimes they don't even come out during the day. It's too muddy and yucky. If we can see him in there. A huge flooding problem in this corner at the intersection, so they've been doing some work in there, and I think their plan is to try and drain it off in there, but hopefully it works. It gets pretty nasty and it pulls all the sand and junk in. This is where I got hit then, right there. Broken bone, did get a couple x-rays and everything came back negative. Come to think of it, my foot hasn't been bothering me for a while. It took quite a while for the swelling to go down. Like I said, it's around 190 or so miles that I do a week, taking them just back and forth from school. This tank gives me around 170, 175 miles before reserve. I'm usually able to then take it out of reserve and make it the rest of the way. That way I just fill up once a week. They've got an aftermarket tank available for this bike that holds an extra half gallon or so. I've just been tempting to buy that. But it's quite a bit of money. Apparently they're not satisfied with the condition of the river yet. They want to make it work. I'm tempting because it's essentially free. Go out there and pick out rocks and sell them. Thank you.
I just put a new front sprocket on this thing. The other one got chewed up in, I don't know, 5,000 miles. It seems ridiculously fast, especially for being an original piece, but it is what it is. Good. I have the new sprocket on. It's not as jerky and smooth at all. I need one back. Now we're back over here to the used car place. You can see that in just that little bit of time we've been gone, it was really, really kind of coming alive here, really filled up. You know, every day they bring the cars in, they wash them. At the end of the day, they take them back, do it again the next day, and that's pretty much a 6 day a week kind of thing. I guess it must be good business or they wouldn't do it. They're still arriving. All these empty spots are, for the most part, pretty much filled right up. Apparently the guy in front of us is shopping for a new car because he's barely moving. Here to the fifth ring. This area here is called La Cuchilla. There's an old GMC. Ooh, what a beast. back there. You can see it's getting pretty rough through here. There's plenty more places to pack as far as that goes, but here's the start. Alright, we'll give Rebecca a honk. Get inside here and my work day will begin. Feels like I got some bathrooms to repair today. There's Fidella. Fidella! Fidella! Fifi! Alright, we are back. We made it. Hope you enjoyed the ride.